A healthy, full head of grain. Nothing better than that for a grower. But unless you plant at the right time, you won't get that. And to work out sowing times, you need good phenology data.
So growers can easily get information about yield ratings and disease resistance when cultivars are released to the market, but not cultivar phenology. Usually this relies on multiple years of field experiments in different sites, different environments. And we also don't have a method that is quantitative and objective and agreed upon by industry that we can use to describe cultivar phenology. So we rely on terms like slow winter and mid-fast spring, but they don't really accurately describe how different cultivars behave in different environments.
In a drive to deliver more accurate modelling of flowering times, the Grains Research and Development Corporation has embarked on an ambitious and intensive research investment.
So this project, it's not just another set of time of sowing experiments. The GRDC National Phenology Initiative is improving the existing APSIM next-gen model for wheat and barley development so that we can parameterise it with controlled environment phenotyping data, molecular markers and or genomic data. And this will allow us to simulate time of sowing in different environments at the point the cultivars are released to the market. So with this improved modelling, we don't need to rely on several years of field experiments anymore to know a cultivar's phenology in a different environment.
The National Phenology Initiative is a highly collaborative and cross-disciplinary undertaking. Partnering with La Trobe University at the CSIRO, Western Australia's Department of Primary Industries and Regional Development, New South Wales Department of Primary Industries, Plant and Food Research New Zealand, the South Australian Research and Development Institute, and the Statistics for the Australian Grains Industry Program, another GRDC investment. Field data will be collected twice weekly over 2 years from sites in Western Australia, South Australia, Victoria, and New South Wales. One of the most important things a grower needs to know about new cultivars is the speed at which they mature. This allows them to sow at the optimum time to maximise yields and minimise losses.
So if we can sow on time and have our cultivars flowering on time, we minimise the risk of yield losses due to frost and heat risk, and we maximise our potential yield.
Critical to the research is the testing across a wide range of Australia's diverse environments to measure the effects of day length and the amount of cool weather the crops are exposed to, that is between -1 and 16 degrees.
So the speed at which wheat and barley develop in the field is a factor of photoperiod, so day length, and light interception, and also their vernalisation requirements. So development speed will vary depending on where they're grown, which environment.
The controlled environment phenotyping, similar to the field experiments, will have the same phenology panel of 96 genotypes, the difference being that researchers are assessing genotype phenology in 4 specific controlled environments, looking at short and long day conditions in combination with plus or minus vernalisation. The phenotypic data that's collected in these experiments, such as emergence date, leaf numbers over time, and thermal time to heading, will be used by the modellers as input parameters to then simulate time of flowering.
Once the model is parameterised with the controlled environment phenotypic data, we're then using the field validation data to test and validate the model. So those two components of the project go hand in hand.
PhD student Max Bloomfield is managing the controlled environment phenotyping at La Trobe University.
And so this phenotyping data is what is the input into the APSIM model. And so it's obviously important because we need to have good data that parameterises the model. And so we've got short or long days with or without vernalisation. And we do this because along with temperature, photoperiod and vernalisation are the environmental drivers of development in wheat and barley.
This wheat-barley combination is a first for the National Phenology Initiative, according to the South Australian Research and Development Institution's barley specialist.
We don't typically have the spread in flowering time in our barley cultivars. We have a much wider spread in our wheat cultivars. So that actually allows us to sow early, often in our wheat cultivars, because we have a wider range of winter germplasm. But I think some of the interesting things we're seeing out of this trial program is that the spring wheats are developing much quicker than barley from some of the earlier sowing dates, but then as we get to the later sowing dates in May, June, the barley is now much quicker than wheat.
These observations are even more meaningful when compared across years. The same trials were run in 2019, providing another layer of valuable data.
If you just compare those 2 years here in South Australia, in autumn last year we had quite a warm autumn. So what that meant for the winter wheats, or the wheats that required vernalisation, they took quite a long time to accumulate their cool period, their cold requirement. Whereas in 2020 we actually had quite a cold autumn in May, June, whereas they saturated their vernalisation requirement very quick. And what that's actually meant is that they're actually flowering maybe 7 to 10 days quicker than they were in 2019. So that really shows to us the genetic by environment interactions that we really have to understand, and that's why we have these field trials.
It's also why germplasm from CSIRO and overseas sources has been included in the trials. Historically, Australian barley breeding programs have included material that is narrow in its diversity and development.
So we really wanted to include the alternative types from CSIRO, and even now the lines coming out of Europe, which are less responsive to photoperiod, because as we move to earlier sowing, these are some of the developmental types that Australian growers will need.
When the first phase of research is complete, this unique tool will be available online from 2022, enabling planning for the 2023 season.
For growers, sowing at the optimal time and having their crop flower at the optimal time is really one of the easiest ways that they can ensure optimal yields on their property. So if we can provide them a tool that can give them this information as soon as a new cultivar is released to market, we're giving them the best chance they can to achieve high yields.
The GRDC Phenology Initiative will also assist growers and advisors to deal with the challenges of climate change.
Not only do growers have to select which cultivars to sow on farm over their sowing period each year, those conditions will change every year, and we're also dealing with a changing climate that's going to have greater impacts down the road. So this tool is going to help inform those cultivar selection and sowing time decisions in their environment.
For the team of researchers, it's demanding but rewarding work.
So I've been working on the National Phenology Initiative for 2 years now, leading the Victorian field trials, and it's really exciting to be involved in a project that's developing such a crucial and important tool for growers and advisors to use. It's straightforward, easy to use, and it's been designed for you. So all this work has gone into the tool for you.
Go to the description bar below for the latest information, links and resources.